As I told you, I'm going to give you few tips how to write a good story and how to make your story best one. Okay, get ready to note down all these ideas. And here are some points to remember while writing a story. What is the topic I have given? Points to remember while writing a story. When you write a story, these are the points you should have in your mind. The first one is, the title should be catchy. Begin the story with a catchy title. What you are going to do? You are going to begin the story with a catchy title. Before you start writing the story, you should have some time to think about the story. What is given? And how you are going to build the story? That is the thing. You should have a mind with ideas. Okay, when you think of it, when you think of the ideas, when you cull out ideas, and when you keep on things, you will get a catchy title over there. Begin the story with a catchy title. The catchy title is the thing which is very important, because it is the one which is going to hold the attention of the reader. It is going to create the interest in the readers to read your story. Yes, no? Do you agree with me? Yes. Catchy title. When we see a book with a good title, we'll feel like getting the book and reading it. We'll feel like getting the book and reading it. The same way, when the readers see a good title for your story, they'll get motivated to read your story. That sort of title you should give. And next, this is the very important point, children. Tense. The tense which you are going to make use of, it should be followed throughout the story. Story is always written in past tense. Here I have given you an idea, children. This is like a trick. Okay? See, this is like a trick. Tense, you can start writing the story in past tense, but see to that you should continue it with past tense till the end. You should not confuse the story with future tense, present tense, continuous tense. That should not happen. Once you start writing the story with past tense, maximum your idea should be in past tense. The verbs, be clear children, the verbs which you are going to use should be in past tense. Only then your story will have a good clarity. If you are going to confuse the tenses, your story will not sound good. And there will be no clarity in your story. So see to that, once you start writing the story in past tense, you should continue it in past tense. Don't mix up the tenses. The first important thing is give a catchy title. And next thing is be careful with the tense. When you make use of a tense, be careful. And next comes word limit. If I'm going to give you a question like, write a story of 150 to 200 words, your story should not be elaborate. It should not be like an essay. It should be like a story of 200 words. Try to follow the word limits. These are the three important areas which you have to be very careful. Be careful in giving a catchy title. Be careful with the tense which you are going to use. And have a check with the word limit. If it is given in the question, write a story of 150 to 200 words, see to that word should not exceed. More or less, you can have 10 words, exceeding 10 words or 20 words. It should not go beyond 20 words. Is it clear for you? Word limit is important. You should not like write stories like an essay. That is not going to create the interest in readers. So follow the word limit. Follow the word limit. And next to that, here I have given you the format of story writing. This is something interesting, children, which I have given it like a box for you. It's like a box. The context. Here, I'm just introducing you the context. How to make use of the phrases. Use phrase like once upon a time. When you use phrase like once upon a time, and you should continue with it happened so. And you can make use of the phrases like long, long ago. So this is the way you are going to begin your story. Once upon a time, it happened so, or long, long ago. I have given you some ideas. I have I have listed you with some ideas. Next comes the introduction of characters. At the beginning, we discussed regarding this, how to introduce the characters. And how you are going to take your story. Whether you are going to write it like a dialogue or you are going to do it like a narration. That plays an important role. Whether your story is going to be like a dialogue or you are the one who is going to do it in a first person narrative. Complete narration of the story. Two forms of stories. Either dialogue or narration. There comes the plot. Plot is nothing but, as I told you, there should be coherence in giving out the ideas. And see to that, the plot should be developed with utmost care. As I told you already, the plot should be developed with utmost care. Description of an event or an accident. That is called as plot, okay? Description of an event or an accident. How we are going to develop the event or how we are going to describe the incident or accident which took place. Am I clear, children? How we are going to describe the event or how we are going to develop the event or how we are going to describe the accident or the incident which took place. You have to be very careful. That revolves around the idea called plot. And when you feel that you are okay with plot, and finally comes climax, the end of the story. The end of the story should be interesting, children. It is not like just giving a full stop. The end of the story should be interesting. The reader should ponder himself with ideas, with questions, when the writer will write next stories. Such a thought he should have for himself. So these are the some ideas which I could discuss with you. Context, how we are going to begin the story, introducing the characters, and plot and climax. That is why I have given you all this in different font colors. If you are going to follow all these tricks in writing stories, I can give you assurance that for sure your story will sound good and you will get good marks. Yes, children, follow these ideas in your story and make your story as the best one. Is it clear? It is better to take down all these points. And now what we are going to do is, I have taught you in a theoretical way how to write a story. Now, this is like a practical way. Till now, I taught you in a theoretical way of writing a story. And now, a step ahead, we are going to write a story. Let's start writing the story now. Okay. Complete the following story in about 150 to 200 words. What is the word limit, children? Word limit plays an important role. 150 to 200 words. So this is the story as it will be given in your board exam. I have given you the question. This is the question with which you are going to develop your story. It was a dark night. There was no one. At 1 a.m. 1 a.m. shows midnight. Okay. There was no one at 1 a.m. Suddenly it started raining. I could hear the noise of cats crying. Suddenly, you are going to continue the story. What you are going to do? You are going to continue. You are going to develop the story. Let us read the story, the question, that is what the introductory part. It was a dark night. There was no one at 1 a.m. Suddenly it started raining. I could hear the noises of cats crying. Suddenly something happened. That's something you are going to develop your story now. And here I'll give you some ideas how to develop the story. Here you can develop your story with these ideas. If you need, you can make a note of it, or else you can continue on your own. Suddenly I heard somebody climbing our stairs. Imagine that you are living in first floor or second floor. 1 a.m. such thing is happening. It is dark night. It started to rain. Suddenly I heard someone climbing our stairs. The sound of footsteps. At first I thought it was someone. At first I thought it was someone. But this is not exactly the second point, children. I am giving you like an idea. I was right and somebody was actually there. I guessed that somebody was there and someone was there. I was just about to pick up my mobile when I heard it ringing. So these are the ideas which I have given you. It is not that this should be the first point, this should be the next point, and this should be the last point. See, here you can see that continue. It continues. This is the way you can develop your story. But it is not that you have to write the points exactly. Develop your story with the question. What is the question I have given you, children? It was a dark night. There was no one. At 1 a.m., suddenly it started raining. I could hear the noise of cats crying. What happened? You are going to develop a story. And this work, you are going to do it in your homework note. Clear, children? You are going to write the story in your homework note. Will you write the story in your homework note? You have to write it in your homework note. And followed by this, I'll give you a story that you can write it in your composition notebook. Start writing the story, children. Until I meet you in the next session, keep yourself endorsed with ideas how to develop the story. Keep on thinking. Don't stop thinking. Okay. Introspect a lot and write your story with better ideas so that your story sounds good. Thank you, children. See you in next session. Bye-bye.